Welcome to the video series, The Operational Amplifier, From Abstraction to Reality. We are definitely in the reality stage, and will now look at how the slew rate ability of an op amp can severely limit the bandwidth of operation with large signals. Let's begin with a little review and clarification. What is rise time? In electronics, when describing a voltage or current step function, rise time is the time taken by a signal to change from a specified low percent value to a specified high percent value. It's usually from 10% to 90% of the signal's amplitude. Sometimes 20% and 80% are used. The key is that it's independent of absolute voltage or current. The voltage or current is not defined, and therefore, it is not slew rate. So what is slew rate? In electronics, slew rate is defined as the change of voltage or current or any other electrical quantity per unit time. Let's say you have a square wave input to a system. The output wave will be limited in rate of change. It is a delta voltage with respect to a delta time and is therefore the slope delta V over delta T. As an example, let's say we have a change of 5 volts in 2 microseconds, which is 2.5 volts per microsecond. If the voltage change was 50 volts in the 2 same microseconds, the slew rate would be 25 volts per microsecond. The change in time is the same. It's important to make this distinction between rise time and slew rate. Why do we have this limitation? Recall from the peak inside the op amp video, this specified schematic of an op amp. Most op amps are internally compensated with a Miller capacitor. This is done for stability. However, when a large step in input voltage occurs, the tail current in the differential pair will saturate, and the amount of current delivered to the compensation capacitor is limited. Therefore, the output will be slewed. Recall the open-loop frequency response of the op amp. It has a really high gain at DC and rolls off with a 20 dB per decade single-pole response. So an op amp is basically an integrator. Note this TL07 series op amp has a 3 MHz unity gain bandwidth. I tested the slew rate of the TL072 ACP in a voltage follower configuration under the test conditions in the datasheet, a 10-volt step, a 2K load resistor, and a 100 picofarad load capacitor. The slope triangle between the cursors spans a 6-volt change in voltage, and the cursor shows a delta T of 536 nanoseconds. The slew rate comes out to 11.2 volts per microsecond. The spec is 13 typical with a minimum of 8 volts per microsecond. So what does this mean for us? We are usually trying to make op amps work across a wide band of frequencies. To figure out how slew rate affects bandwidth, we need to know the rate of change of the highest frequency used in the system. The rate of change of a sinusoid is maximum at its zero crossings, so we need to know exactly what the slope is. Let's start with the equation of a sinusoid. We want to differentiate with respect to time, first moving the constant V sub P out to the left. We will use the chain rule on that puppy, and of course the derivative of sine of x is the cosine of x. That leaves us with this equation representing the derivative of a sine wave. We are interested in the maximum rate of change. Of course, the cosine function is maximum or 1 at 0 and 180 degrees. So this part goes away. That leaves us with this simple equation for the maximum slew rate for a given peak voltage and frequency. Now let's see how much the slew rate is limiting bandwidth. Rearranging the equation for frequency, we can calculate the slew rate limited bandwidth. we will go with most of the output range of the op amp at 20 volts peak to peak or 10 volts peak. Using the 11.2 volts per microsecond we measured yields 178.3 kHz. Recall, the unity gain bandwidth of this part is 3 MHz. The slew rate limited bandwidth at unity gain is only 5.9% of the unity gain bandwidth. Let's go check it out on the bench. The top green trace is the signal generator input, as close as I could dial for the 178.3 kHz, 20 volts peak to peak input and output. Note the slope of the sine wave. I'm increasing the frequency of the input. You can see it begin to distort and become triangular. Now at this higher frequency, reducing the amplitude brings the output back to a undistorted sinusoid. We did the observation based on the slew rate we measured. The datasheet has a minimum slew rate of only 8 volts per microsecond. That gives us a slew rate limited bandwidth of only 127.3 kHz. That's just 4.2% of the unity gain bandwidth at unity gain. Now I'm inputting a 3 MHz sine wave input at 1 volt peak to peak. I consider that a small signal. Now let's see what amplitude causes us a slew limit. Just 1.5 volts peak to peak distortion occurs. How can we do better? Well, we can choose a different op amp. I mentioned how this compensation capacitor was the major contributor to the slew rate dilemma. Some op amps are available uncompensated. This requires the designer to select an appropriate external compensation capacitor. These op amps have not gained much popularity since most users don't want to bother with the extra effort to make sure it's stable. There are also decompensated op amps that have a moderate amount of compensation inside but does require external capacitors. It appears the best solution for achieving high large signal slew rate is a current feedback amplifier. They have excellent slew rate capabilities. The current feedback architecture is inherently faster. With a current feedback amplifier, the low impedance input allows higher transient currents to flow into the amplifier as needed. The internal current mirrors convey this input current to the compensation node, allowing fast charging and discharging, theoretically in proportion to input step size. The faster slew rate will result in a quicker rise time, lower slew-induced distortion, and nonlinearity. It also has a wider large signal frequency response. Here is an example of a current feedback op amp with a blazing 7300 volts per microsecond slew rate at an output amplitude of 20 volts peak to peak. One trade-off for this performance is extra power consumption, which is intuitive. A popular feature for these devices is a power-down pin to put the device to sleep when not in use. And for all this, you must pay. While many op amps are less than a dollar, this one is about $11. In summary, always evaluate and test for slew rate limitations for any design requiring large signal outputs. Thanks for watching. Please click the like, subscribe, and notification bell so you don't miss any upcoming content.